नमस्कार स्टूडेंट्स, इन माय लास्ट वीडियो आई हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट टू टाइप्स ऑफ हेटरोट्रॉफिक मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन, दैट इज पैरासिटिक एंड इंसेक्टिवोरस प्लांट। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट सैप्रोट्रॉप्स।
यू माइट हैव सीन पैकेट्स ऑफ मशरूम सोल्ड इन द वेजिटेबल मार्केट। यू मे हैव ऑल्सो सीन फ्लफी अम्ब्रेला लाइक पैचेस ग्रोइंग ऑन रॉटिंग वुड ड्यूरिंग द रेनी सीजन। Let us find out what type of nutrients they need to survive and from where they get them. Okay, you can see the mushrooms packed. Okay, now let's see the Bojo's statement. Okay, Bojo wants to know how these organisms acquire nutrient. They do not have mouths like animals do. They are not like green plant as they lack chlorophyll and cannot make food by photosynthesis. We will find the answer here. Okay, these organisms are called fungi. They have a different mode of nutrition. They secrete digestive juices on the dead and decaying matter and convert it into a solution. Then they absorb the nutrients from it. This mode of nutrition in which organism take in nutrients in solution form from dead and decaying matter is called saprophytic nutrition. Plants which use saprotrophic mode of nutrition are called saprophytes. Here is an activity given to grow a bread mold, which is a kind of fungi, on bread slice. But as we are passing through a very critical situation, we cannot waste even a single slice of bread. So we will just observe the growth of the fungi on the bread slice here in this in this picture. But let's go through the activity. Okay, take a piece of bread and moisten it with water. Leave it in a moist warm place for 2 to 3 days. You know, for the growth of microbes, the moist and warm place is must. Clear? Or until fluffy patches appear on them. These patches may be white, green, brown, or of any other color. Observe the patches under a microscope or magnifying glass. You can observe under magnifying glasses. So what we'll see? You see here the growth of fungi. Okay, as I said, no need to do this activity at home for now. Later we can think of that. Clear? Okay, now here. Pahali is keen to know whether her beautiful shoes, which she wore on special occasions, were spoiled by fungi during the rainy season. She wants to know how fungi appear suddenly during the rainy season. So, you can find the answer here. The fungal spores are generally present in the air. When they land on wet and warm things, they germinate and grow. As I said, for the growth of this microbes required wet and warm conditions, climatic condition. Okay, now can we figure out how we can protect our things from getting spoiled? I have already mentioned that fungi grow well in hot and moist condition or warm and moist condition. So we must keep our things in dry places and clean them regularly, okay, to avoid that situation. Here you can see the microbial growth on different things. It's a leather bag, jam, shoes, bags, even on seat covers. Okay, let's be the part of Bujo and Pahali's conversation. Okay, Bujo says that once his grandfather told him that his wheat field were spoiled by a fungus. He wants to know if fungi cause diseases also. Pahali told him that many fungi like yeast and mushroom are useful, but some fungi cause diseases in plants, animals and humans. Some fungi are also used in medicine. We can see here the fungal growth on wheat plant that has covered completely, and you know, this infection can kill the whole crop. You can see here that due to this fungal growth, some patches are grown on this fruits, leaves, and this is a maize,
in papaya and spoiled all that. So you can see here this growth becomes scanty due to the growth of fungus here. Clear? Okay. It also causes disease in humans like ringworm, athlete's foot, etc. You can see all this, its patches and all that. Huh? To protect ourselves from these fungal diseases, we need to keep ourselves clean. Take bath every day. Dry yourselves properly and try to wear clean clothes. And of course, keep your surroundings clean. But it's not like that, that fungi are always harmful. As Pahali said also, it is useful too. Yeast is a kind of fungi that are used in the making of bread, cake, cheese, all this. Some mushrooms are edible too, but not all. Keep that in mind, okay? Some fungi are also used in the making of some medicines that called antibiotics. Clear? Next, we will read about symbiotic plants. Now, some organisms live together and share shelter and nutrient. This is called symbiotic relationship. For example, certain fungi live in the roots of trees. The trees provides nutrients to the fungus and in return receives help from it to take up water and nutrients from the soil. This association is very important for the tree. We will try to understand this symbiotic relationship with the help of an example. Okay. Now what is that? We will discuss about lichens. Lichens are actually a plant that having a close association with fungi. Here the plant part is formed by the alga which contains chlorophyll. So in lichen, alga and fungi lives in a symbiotic relationship where alga provides food as it can perform photosynthesis and fungi provide shelter, water and mineral to alga. You can see the growth of lichen on tree trunks. A very common feature you can see on the trees, okay? And it is formed by the symbiotic relationship between fungus and algae, okay? You can see clearly over here. These are the green parts are the algal part and these are the non-green parts are fungal one. Clear? So, today we have discussed about the saprotrophs and symbiotic plants. In my next video, I will discuss about how nutrients are replenished in soil. Namaskar.